चले एक छोटा सा हिंदी के समझाएंगे।
जय राधा माधव कुंज Thank you.
clean it once. So that one. I mean, even, you know, proper etiquette.
No, one was a long game.
White.
His speed is growing.
Very well, everyone. Thank you so much for coming. Apologies who have my back to here on the stage. Firstly, I'd like to welcome Sabdi Maharaj to our home with Seva Kunj. Jay! And as you can see, we have prepared it specially for you. It will go back the old way after you go. And thank you so much, everyone, for coming. And the whole point of having association is so that we can improve our bhakti gradually and slowly gear our life towards Krishna consciousness. And there's no better way to do that than with Sadhu Sangha. And that's why we are so fortunate to have Maharaj here today and all of you here today to spread Harikatha through the vibrations of the wall and to remind us that this is the whole point of our human birth. So thank you everyone for coming, and I'll hand it over to my father.
Enlighten everyone. Prakash means enlighten. Enlighten everyone. Hare Krishna.
Om Agyanam Dhinandasya Gyanam Jana Sarathaya Takshurmin Kamilina Pasmai Shri Guru. So today is a very auspicious day for all of us that we have gathered here, and we have not only gathered here just for pleasure, but we have gathered here in association with Sadhu, and being with Sadhu so much importance, and so much importance has been given by our Shastra, and of course most of you know what the Nauda Bhakti is, and the first one of the Nauda Bhakti is for, we have to listen. Until we listen, we cannot progress in the path of bhakti. Or when we listen, and whom should we listen to, is also so important. And we are so fortunate that Maharaji is here from Vrindavan. He has been, he has had association with so many great Vaishnavas. His own Guru Maharaj, Pramod Puri Swami Maharaj, and then he had so fortunate that he also went into Seva with Gurudev Shri Bhakti Shri Narayan Goswami Maharaj. And Maharaji has rendered so much service there in Vrindavan. He was in charge of book translation, and he has. So now we can say that Maharaj is really pakka in his Siddhanta. That's why Gurudev has given him sannyas name of Siddhanti Maharaj.
Of Siddhanta.
So I can't emphasize how important it is that in such a auspicious month of Purushottam Mass, where we have gathered here to do kirtan, bhajan, and listen to some wise word of wisdom from Maharaji. So I won't take much of your time, and I'll request Maharaji to enlighten us with some.
You can take my time. Gentlemen, inconceivable. Make us
Last 3 weeks in Brisbane we've been discussing
Upadeshamita, as I say, so Bhaktivinoda Thakur on the second verse and third verse of Upadeshamita. So every time Bhaktivinoda Thakur comes to the end point of doing sadhu sang, if you talk sadhu sang, we cannot remove all our impurities, whatever is destroying our bhakti, whatever is progressing actually. And also you mentioned one thing about sadhu sang. There are three qualities of sadhu sang. One is more advanced than us. One is in the same line of us, and then also in the same, and was affectionate to us. So we are very fortunate, actually, you know, I mean, there could be different sadhus going here and there. But unless we come to our sadhus that is in the same line of us, it's very important that this thing, that will make our faith grow stronger. That's what Prakash Prabhu was saying, that, you know, Shripad Sansidhanti Maharaj is so fortunate to serve his own Guru Maharaj, Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, Srila Gurudev, and also Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj. So much Siddhanti, and so much things he have heard, and so much instruction, especially like different acharyas give different perspectives of life. For example, Srila Gurudev was mainly in Siddhanta, and what is establishing a goal, while Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj used to give examples from his own life, you know, how he practiced. You know, because it's very rare, because generally devotees are very humble, they don't want to speak about themselves. You know, they don't want to say what they have done, but Srila Bharati Goswami Maharaj, you know, very taking the mood that at least, you know, by what I have practiced, you know, what I have done, at least another devotee is in full of, you know, Srila. So Srila Siddhanti Maharaj was fortunate enough to save him as well. So we are very fortunate, especially in this Purushottam month, to hear sadhus, you know, what especially is what is beneficial for us, because we are very fallen, and as you can see that, you know, without sadhusan, we struggle in bhakti, you know, we have different obligations and different duties, and that drags us away from bhakti. But unless we come to these sadhus, you know, that who have served the Vaishnavas with their own lives, not served Vaishnavas, and the practical examples, you know, they will, so we are very fortunate that
अज्ञान विभ्रांतस्य ज्ञानञ्जन चक्षुरुम्लितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकाय सदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः। वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णेभ्यो नमो नमः। संसार दुख जलदस्य पतितस्य काम क्रोधाद नक्रमक्ल कवरी कृतस्य दुर्वासनस्य निगिडितस्य निराशयस्य चैतन्य चंद्र मम देहि पदावलम्बम्। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीन बंधु जगतपते गोपेश गोपीकांत राधाकांत नमोस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी हनुमामि हरिप्रिये। श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्त वृंदा। ऑल टुगेदर
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे
राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। वन मोर टाइम लाउडली
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे।
By the causeless mercy of our Gurudev and the Vaishnavas. Thank you. We have assembled here and our dear host Madhuri Didi and Nayan Prabhu hosting this wonderful program here at Gold Coast, at the coast of the gold. I assume there is so much gold here. That's why this place is Gold Coast. And in this auspicious Purushottam month, the month of Purushottam, there are three Purushottams. Maryada Purushottam Ram, Leela Purushottam Krishna, and the combined form of Radha Krishna, Prem Purushottam Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And because this place is Gold Coast, Mahaprabhu is golden avatar. His golden avatar. कान में फिर वो आवाज ज्यादा नहीं है लाइक दिस हरि बोल हरे कृष्णा रेडी फॉर टेक ऑफ गोल्ड कोस्ट या दिस इज बेटर सो आई वाज वंडरिंग व्हाट इज दिस गोल्ड अबाउट Gold is so expensive. It's not cheap, right? Wood is cheap, iron is cheap, silver is more expensive, and gold is very expensive. And we are at the coast of the gold. Actually, we are in Gold Coast, in this material world.
We are very fortunate we are in this line, and we heard from Srila Gurudev various topics, the insight stories of Maryada Purushottam Sri Ram, Leela Purushottam Sri Krishna. So Gurudev used to say, don't try to imitate Krishna. Even if you try to imitate, you are failure. So don't even attempt for that. Because you can't lift a brick for 7 days and 7 nights on the pink fish. So don't ever try this. And on the top of that, don't even try to marry 16,182. You can't do that. And don't try to dance with 100 million gopis. It's inconceivable. This is told by our acharyas. You can't imitate the pastime of Krishna. But we are there to follow the standards established by Maryada Purushottam Sri Ram. To get entrance into that divine realm of bhakti, which is propagated as well as practiced by the golden avatar, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Keep your phone silent. The word I will take now. Is it iPhone? No?
I think my mom's trying to dial in some book number now.
So, if she wants to hear, then to get entrance into that bhakti which is propagated and practiced by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the golden avatar. There's a pastime In the Leela of Sri Ram, Maryada Purushottam, we all know very familiar about Ram Leela. Especially we are Fijians here. They are fond of Ram Leela. So anything to do with gold in Ram Leela? Since we are at Gold Coast, let us glorify gold. Any? Past
time gold, then East is gold.
Golden avatar. Ram Leela. Okay. Nobody has gone Ram with the rope of Maryada. But he himself accepted this bondage of in the boundaries of Maryada. That's the sweetness of his pastime. To establish that complete Maryada and to fulfill all his pastimes, he chose some foundation. We see specifically these three avatars. Actually, they are not avatars, they are avataris. But why we address them avataris is because avatar means one who descend from spiritual world to this material world. That process of descending is called avatar. So Sri Ram, to establish that Maryada, there's always some foundation needed for the pastimes. What is the greatest foundation? To fulfill the desire of Sri Ram to establish his Maryada and to accomplish many other pastimes. Not only just to kill the demons, not only just to reciprocate with his devotees who are longing to see him in the forest and other places. But the most important factor, which is common in these three avatars, is to relish and taste a very special flavor. That flavor is called Vipralambha, the mood of separation. And that's the only purpose, not only, but one of the important purpose for them to descend from the eternal abode to this material world. Lord Sri Ram, he descended from his eternal abode, Saketa Dham. Why do you have to come here? Was there no enough happiness and pleasure? Did they have to come from their eternal abode, from the spiritual abode, to this material planet? Why? For some very special purpose. And Chaitanya Chaitamrita Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami says, Vaikuntha Adre Yogi Leela Nahi Prachar Se Se Leela Karibo Jate Mor Chamatkar. I want to get astonished. I want to get amazed with my own pastimes. And that can only happen when I come on this planet. Those pastimes I'm not able to relish or taste or even manifest in my eternal world. Golabrinda or Saketa. So, Vipralambha, the mood of separation, which is not there. There's always eternal union there. They're together all times. But separation always enhances the flavor of meeting. Our Acharya Sri Rupa Goswami Pada described Vina Vipralambhena Sambho Pushti Vishnu. Without separation, there is no taste, no pleasure in meeting. In other words, separation enhances that flavor of meeting. In regular days, you're together, husband wife staying together, there is love, but it becomes very regular, very normal, like a one stream. But if you put some obstruction in that, obstruction of some little separation, not that separation, but let's say you have to go for business. The husband has to go out for business for 2 years. And wife, she's like waiting and longing, when are you going to come back? Come soon, finish your project quick. She remembers her husband more. And husband remembers her, his wife more than in the regular situation. This is called a taste of flavor. So Vipralambha, separation mood is like this. Which Lord Shri Ram, he also wants to taste. And he wants his consort Sita Devi also to relish this. Understand? There's a prime purpose. To taste Vipralambha. So, that's the prime purpose. But to taste that, they need to make one foundation, a drama. And that foundation is what? He chose Kakai. Anybody has name Kakai? Any daughters? Only one Kakai. There cannot be more than one Kakai because Kakai is the foundation of Ramlila. The boons which she asked from Sri Dasharatha Maharaj. The foundation of Ramlila is Kakai. And other foundation of Ramlila is Bharat. Bharat has so much sacrifice and Sakhi has so much sacrifice. So mother and son both together. So much sacrifice. And the entire relishing of different moods by Ram and his associates, all associates, Hanuman, Sugriv, Angad and all, Nal and Neel, especially Shri Ram and Shri Sita Devi. The foundation is Kakai and Bharat because of the sacrifice. And therefore, Shri Ram is in the forest. Is he enjoying there? With his consort, with his wife Sita Devi and Lakshman? Yes, he's enjoying there. He always, the Lord always enjoys. Even if he manifests his opulence, he's enjoying. And even if he manifests his renunciation, he's enjoying. If he manifests his knowledge, he's enjoying. If he manifests his beauty, he's enjoying. Aishwarasya, samagrasya, virasya, yasya. If he manifesting his strength, he's enjoying. If he manifesting his yash, his fame, he's enjoying. His all activity is there to enjoy. And why not? His Supreme Lord. We can't blame him. Why you always enjoy? Today, this morning, I was in flight, I was thinking. Many people, especially in India, they start blaming the Lord. Why are you doing this? Why you made this material world? Hey, who are you to say what? Who created this? Wait a minute. Who created this universe? I mean, I'm the owner of this house. Whatever I want to do, I'm independent to do. I want to sit there, I want to eat there, whatever I want to do. That's my house. Right? No one can check my independence here. All these universes are created by Lord. This is his house, his home. He's independent Lord. He can do whatever he wants. Who are we to say why he did that? But still, to teach us a lesson, he established Maryada. That is his sweetness of his pastime. Therefore, to taste and relish this Vipralambha, the separation mood, while he was in forest. So this is already begun. That's why he inspired Kakai to go and ask father the two boons. Creating that foundation for just one goal. Tasting Vipralambha, the mood of separation. Try to catch this point. Which is not present in Saket Bhav. Only the Bhav, the mood. And that's why he came. All this complete entourage is here. In creating this, the whole scene. And then in the forest, Sita Devi, who's who has so much renunciation, unparalleled renunciation, Sita Devi. Focus this point. She is born, raised in so much opulence by Sri Janak Maharaj. Was she from poor family? Her feet, the sole of her lotus feet was so soft, more soft than lotus. More soft. Even when she step on lotus, she feel hurt. Even if she step on a lotus, the petal of the lotus. That soft. And when she got married, Sri Dashar Maharaj said, Sita, you are more dear than the pupil of my eye. You're so dear to me. You're like my daughter. So all opulences were there. But without caring for any opulence, she showed the high renunciation. She went with Ram in the forest. Without wearing any ornaments, without wearing shoes. That's soft lotus feet in the forest. With sharp edges, stones and thorns and all that. And for many reasons. So question arises. If she is manifesting so much renunciation, if she is showing up so much renunciation, then why in the middle of the forest, seeing a golden deer? That's the gold post above. A golden deer. Yes, deer? She saw a golden deer. And she expressed, oh Ram, I want this thing. And Ram trying to pacify her. No, Sita, this is forest. There's so many rakshas, demons in the forest. We don't know. They can assume any form. So don't be greedy for this golden deer. No, I want this deer. Why is she showing so much attachment to a deer? She's with Ram. She already renounced everything. All her opulence, all her comforts, all luxuries, everything. And now all of a sudden she is expressing so much enjoying mood. It's contradictory to her nature. Why I want this golden deer? Why?
Because at the moment they're still meeting is there. No separation is there. She is a different Sita.
The Leela was born to happen?
The original Sita was given to this fire and this Chaya Sita came the day before.
With a golden deer?
The Chaya Sita from more attraction to him. She got attracted to the material.
Because she wants to take all the blame on her head of killing or destroying the demonic dynasty. She don't want Ram to get any blame. That's the nature of the Shakti, the Surup Shakti. If Sri Ram is going to kill all the demons, then anyone can blame him. There has to be a cause. There has to be a reasoning. Ram to destroy the demonic dynasty. The demonic mood. Ravan, Kumkaran and all others. So, everything started with a golden deer. She inspired Ram, please get me this golden deer. And Ram has to go there. Ram has to go there. Who's creating this scene? The Yog Maya potency. Why this scene is being created? To taste that separation. Until now they were union. Always together. But now we need a different flavor. So therefore, Ram start Ram chased the deer, and deer took Ram long, far distance. And that deer was Marich, demon. And then, same voice like Ram, he started calling out, Lakshman, Lakshman, Lakshman. And Sita Devi, she inspired Lakshman, go and help and save your brother Ram. Lakshman said, no. No one can harm my brother Ram. No one can. No, Lakshman, you have to go. And then she said some very difficult words. I know why you're not going. You want to enjoy with me. And Lakshman kind of told those words. He closed his ears. What are you saying? Then he draw a line. Don't step out of this. You are safe in the line. Don't go out of the line. And from that point onwards, all this scene happened. Ravan came, kidnapped Chaya Sita. Ravan kidnapped. And then, killing demons was not the purpose. But Sita Devi is in Ashok Vatika, in Lanka. And Shri Ram is in the forest. Ha Sita, Ha Sita, where are you Sita, where are you Sita? Oh trees, have you seen my Sita? Oh earth, have you seen my Sita? Sita, Sita, Lakshman came. There's something I'm noticing. Your face is smiling and effulgent, but tears are also coming from your eyes. I don't understand. You're crying or you're happy? It's so confusing. I don't understand. It's so confusing. You seem like sad, but you're also very effulgent and happy, smiling face. Because here Shri Ram is relishing, tasting that separation mood. Calling out, Sita, Sita, Sita. And Sita Devi is in Ashok Vatika. Ashok means where there is no lamentation. And what she is doing there? Shok, lamentation. Calling out Ram, weeping and crying. Ram, 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 Ram. In separation. At Ashok Vatika. Ashok means where there is no lamentation. So how we can say she is lamenting? It's not lamentation. She is tasting that separation mood. Who can understand? That's the astonishing feature of Krishna Prem. Ehi Prem Aswada Tapt Ikshu Charvan Mukhe Jwala Nahai Tirajan. Ehi Prem Aswada. Tasting this prem is just like in India, back home, they used to sugar cane juice, also maybe in Fiji. They make sugar cane with a process grinding, and sugar cane juice, they boil that, and it's so delicious. One takes sip by sip. The tongue is burning, but it's so delicious. A prem aswadam tapt ikshu charvan mukhe jwala nahai tyajan. Mukhe jwala means the lip, the tongue is burning, but it's so delicious, it's so tasty, no one wants to give up. This is the astonishing feature of Krishna prem. Bhare vishe jwala hai bhitre anandmay Krishna prem albut charit. Externally appearing, the person is sad, lamenting, crying and weeping. But inside, tasting bliss. Tasting that bliss. It looks like contradictory. But this is what is all about Krishna prem, the love of Krishna. Which is compared to as gold in nature. Srila Prabhupada used to say, gold in nature means golden nature means? This is so powerful. And compared to as the milk of she lion. The milk of she lion is very strong. If you try to hold that in any other pot, in any other metal, it make a hole and fall on the ground. You can't hold in any pot, in any container, in any vessel. The milk of she lion always have to be a golden pot. The golden pot. One time, one lady disciple of Srila Gurudev, she heard Gurudev has some heart problem. She said, Gurudev, I will bring the milk of she lion for you. Because that's very strong for the heart, very good for the heart. Gurudev said, good luck. You go and milk she lion, if you can save, then of course you bring for me. So he said, the milk of she lion is so strong, can only be held in the golden pot. And this is compared to as Krishna prema. The divine loving service of Radha and Krishna is also compared to as golden, is also compared to as very powerful and can only be held in the golden pot. Golden pot means, as Gaur Kishoredas Babaji Maharaj used to say, Gaur Amar, Mukhe Bole Nahi Chale. Just by saying, oh, Mahaprabhu is mine, Mahaprabhu is mine, is not going to work over there. Gaur Achar, Gaur Vichar. Following Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the standards he established, following that standard, one can have access to that Krishna prema, which is make a person gold in nature. How to make that person gold in nature? By coming. It's so difficult. Listen, I'm getting a little noise from you. It is so difficult to turn out to very precious, glittering, golden nature. Because the consciousness is not very elevated, it's just like iron in its iron pH. It's like iron. How to become that iron? How to turn that iron into gold? Iron cannot be turned into gold. The properties of iron and properties of gold is different. Yeah? You cannot turn iron into gold. There's only one way. Put that iron bar touch to a chintamani. Touch that iron bar with chintamani. What is chintamani? Desire fulfilling joy. Chintamani. And if you touch iron with chintamani, iron turns into gold. Immediately, just by the touch. What is that chintamani which can make us from that iron-like consciousness to very powerful and precious golden-like consciousness to become capable and efficient enough to serve the golden avatar? What is that? Chintamani? Naam Chintamani Krishna. Chetan Niras Vigraha. Poor Shuddha Nitya Mukto Abhinatya Nama Nama. The only one way is Naam Chintamani. What is that Naam Chintamani means? Chanting the holy name. Chant, chant, chant. Chant the holy name. And like Dubhi Sevi. Harir Naam Eva Kevalam. Eva means very specifically, Eva only. By coming in contact with holy name. But we are all chanting holy name. My consciousness is still very bad. It's not elevated yet. Many of us were chanting 20 years, 30 years. What is the whole idea of chanting or reading or worshipping? Elevation of consciousness. From iron to gold. If there is no elevation of consciousness, my all practices have no meaning. Consciousness, elevation of consciousness, very important. How the elevation of consciousness takes place? If we have to go elevation on a building, hey, merge up. If we have to go 22nd floor, Raghunath Prabhu, which floor is that? You know, rooftop? 23 rows. 23 floor. It's so difficult to climb stairs, right? Elevator, right? Lift. We need lift for elevator. So, elevation. We need a device, a system to elevate to go to 23rd floor. Our practice, our sadhana is not to go 23 floor, we have only 9 floor. That is sufficient for us. Only 9 floor. Shraddha, sadhusam, bhajan kriya, anatnivritti, nishtha, ruchi, asakti, bhav, prema. Satisfied in just 9 floor. But there are many other floors, prathe rasa. After that, prem, then after prem, sneh, maan, prane, raag, anurag, bhav, modan, madan, modanam. So, 9, 18, 19th floor. But we can't reach to 19th floor. That's only Radharani. Rur Adhirur. 19th floor. Elevation of consciousness, very important. What is my perception? Everyone's perception is not the same. Srila Gurudev, he used to speak Harikatha, but everyone is not having the same perception. Even understanding who is Sri Guru, who is understanding the activities of Ram, the activities of Krishna, the activities of, means the pastimes of Mahaprabhu. Everyone's perception is not same. Everyone's perception is not like gold. There's contaminations in the perceptions also. This contamination in the perception. That's why Srila Bhaktivedanta Vaman Gosai Maharaj. How many of you have seen him? He used to say in Bengali, Tumar China Bhakti Pragyan, Amar China Bhakti Pragyan Ek Nai. That means, he used to say to his godmothers, your understanding of Guru Maharaj Shri Bhakti Pragyan and my understanding of Guru Maharaj Shri Bhakti Pragyan is not same. Gurudev is same figure. His lecture, his delivering lecture to 1,000 people, everyone's not perceiving same. Perception is different. And that's all, perception is all about consciousness. Where is my consciousness is? But by constantly hearing with pure mind, pure heart, with a mood of adoption, not with a mood of just learning and gathering information. It's two different moods. With a mood of adoption comes the elevation of consciousness. And it happens, this happens by chanting Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Hare Ram. But if someone is chanting 64 rounds or 100 rounds, but still the perception is same as it was before, or the consciousness is still on the same level as it was before, It's just like anchor. The ship is not moving, it's anchored. The consciousness is same. That means something is lacking there. And what is that lacking? Some missing link is there. That missing link is higher association. Gurudev always used to say, higher association, higher association, higher association. If we are having same like association, it's not going to elevate us. We need elevator to go 23rd floor. Higher consciousness. Along with Naam Chintamani Krishna. If we want to transform the iron into gold, iron itself cannot come into gold, but by touch with Chintamani can easily turn into gold. And that's why, you know, goldsmith, if you see goldsmith, we used to say in India, they burn, you know, sometimes gold, like Suloshna Mataji, she has sold gold.
Oh, okay.
I know. That's okay. She has so much gold. And she's keeping since when she got married, since then. Almost 30 years? How many years, Mataji? 30-40 years? Then gold turns to black, right? If it is in the locker, it becomes black. Huh? 24-24. So what gold will do?
Polish.
Polish means he gives. I saw in India, that's the Indian side. They burn that gold. They get heat. They burn that gold. The more you burn, it becomes glittering, shiny. Therefore, if a sadhaka practitioner is not burning himself or herself, in this practice, in this sadhana, cannot turn into gold. And the consciousness going to remain same. Sadhak means burning to become gold. It's not easy to get success. Burning. With which formula, as he was saying, carrying Udeshamrit, Aptyahar Vyasascha, Prajalto Niyamagraha, Jan Sangha Salolyamcha, Shadvibhakti. The six factors which destroy our bhakti. What are those six factors? Aptyahar. The very first thing is Aptyahar. What is the meaning of Aptyahar? In the book?
All the senses.
Yes. General meaning of atyahar means overeating. But overeating is not the only meaning. Atyahar means eating from all the senses. Can you eat with your eyes? Jyotam Prabhu?
Yes.
Yep.
Yes?
Yeah.
Well, eat. You can eat some eyes and ears and nose.
Then we are Lord.
Huh?
Then we are Lord.
Eating with eyes means what? Adoption of that association. As Ajamil did. Ajamil was a Brahmin, following the Brahminical culture. But Ajamil was in forest and he saw a hunter and a prostitute meeting together. So he ate with his eyes. He adopted that. The adoption. He accepted that adoption. He got associated with that scene. As Sabri Rishi. He was in waters for thousands of years. Meditation. Complete isolation. not on the land, in water. There is no one to disturb. Complete isolation in waters. But he gave with his eyes. He saw male and female fish mating together. Adoption. Scenes are everywhere. But if you are adopting those scenes or if you are not adopting those scenes, that depends on person to person. Adoption. Similarly, association of sadhu is also a matter of adoption. Only just coming together and hearing is not called association, Baba. It's not called association. But adoption of that association, then it turns to iron to gold. With adoption of association, not only hearing. I'm hearing from 30 years. Nothing is happening. And there's so many examples, I only heard one time. And there is so much transformation. One time only. Narad, in his previous life, he heard only 3 months, 4 months. 4 months, Chaturmasya this time. He heard from sannyasis, exalted Vaishnavas, devotees. When he heard, seriously adopted them. Sincerely adopted them. He totally changed. In my lifetime, there are so many Chaturmasya things. No change. I'm still there. My anchor is just there. Even one. Yad anuchat krila karna kush vipurat. In Bhramar Gita, Radharani is saying this. Yad anucharita leela karna piyush vipur. Even one Krishna katha enters in the ear, one only. Gives a tremendous effect and tremendous transformation. One Krishna katha. And we are hearing from so many ears. There is no lack of Harikatha. There is a flow of Harikatha. The problem is with adoption. I'm scared to adopt that because if I adopt that, I cannot enjoy. The problem is with the enjoyment. That's the consciousness. Inbuilt consciousness. This is a device. Inbuilt, by default. By birth, by default, enjoying consciousness. There's a truth, a bitter truth. Therefore, association is there and we obstruct that adoption with our own enjoying mood. If I try to adopt what Gurudev said, then I can't enjoy. Therefore, I'm going to adopt slight, small amounts. An immediate adoption, where are we? Renunciation. Radhe Radhe. Vrindavan mein Radhe Radhe. And the leap mein Gaur Gaur. Bas. Hari Bolo. Atyahar. Eating with eyes. Eating with ears, eating with nose, sense of touch. Oh, of course, this is prayasas cha, over endeavoring. So, atyahar, overeating means whatever your appetite, if you eat that, that's fine. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada saying, yatha yogya bhog nahi tavaro. Whatever is essential, because we have to survive, we have to see, we have to hear, we have to smell, we have to eat, we have to touch. So that much which is essential for survival, that is not atyahar. We need this because we can't survive without that. We can't survive without that. So up till the survival rate is fine. But beyond that turns to atyaha. If I can eat 3 chapatis, that's my appetite. And instead of 3, today Prakash Prabhu, Karuna Mataji made so much. Dokla and all, I already saw. Don't think I'm only speaking very well. I'm also looking there. So if I eat more than what I can, it's atyaha. And it's not about eating, it's also about actually vision. It's very important. We see advertisement, the hoarding. And many scenes around us. And we immediately adopt that. That's adoption is very easy. Because that enhances my enjoying more. That enhances my, that's nature, that's, you know, we are understanding the nature, that enhances my enjoying mood. When moment sadhu comes, sat eva chindanti mano vyaksava muktabhi. They carry sword, not in their hands, but in their mouth. Their words so hurtful. Their words are very sharp. Like a sword. And it's not very palatable to the ears. But those words is cutting that mood of enjoyment. For what reason? Why we have to struggle so much for this? Because we want to turn into gold. From iron-like consciousness to gold-like consciousness. Then one becomes qualified. Actually qualified to serve the golden avatar, Sri Sachinandan Gaurav. Don't take Mahaprabhu very easy going. Mahaprabhu is not easy going. Many devotees say, oh, worship Radha Krishna is difficult, they take offense. Mahaprabhu is easy. He forgives all offense. Is it?
No.
Mahaprabhu is so calculative also and very strict. With rules and regulations. You can't take for granted. Mahaprabhu is not that easy going. He's practicing and showing that standard. How you can get this?
Good.
Krishna Prem. And Mahaprabhu is compared to as Vish Amrit Ekatra Milan. A pot of nectar and poison together. How is possible? Can nectar and poison be together? Can darkness and sunlight be together? Krishna Suresam Maya Andhakar. Jaha Krishna Taha Nahi Maya Adhikar. Wherever Krishna is present, Maya cannot be there. Yes or no? Suppose if Krishna is there, which side Maya will going to take? Where is she going to stand by Krishna? Behind? What is the evidence? Maya tatpadashrayam. Bhakti yogena manasi samyak prakapyamale apashya purusham purnam maya tatpadashrayam. Shri Vyasadev in his samadhi, instructed by Shri Narada, in samadhi he saw Param Purusha Shri Krishna with all his pastimes and he saw Maya behind him. How one can understand this is Maya? Only because of the presence of Krishna. Maya itself has no individual existence. Her existence is only because of Krishna. Just like, it's so funny. Sun is covered by clouds. Right? But how you can see the sun? Only because of the presence of the sun. How you can see the cloud? Because of the presence of the sun. Yes? Sun is covered by clouds, dark clouds. But how you see clouds? Because of the presence of sun. Maya is what? Which is not. Maya, Mayati. How we can, we are in Maya. There is no doubt. But what is the existence of Maya? The existence of Maya is because of the existence of Krishna. But with the Maya, one cannot see Krishna. But with Krishna, we can see Maya. We can understand the external energy Maya. Understand? We have here away. With the presence of sun, we can see the clouds, even though clouds has covered the sun. Jahan Krishna tahi ta nahi maya adhikar. Wherever there is Krishna, there is Maya has no influence there. Yeah. But I'm not able to have Krishna all the time, the proximity of Krishna all the time with me. And that's why I'm in Maya. No. One devotee told Srila Bhaktivinoda Swami Prabhupada. He said, Prabhupada, because we practice in Krishna consciousness, sometimes we fall in Maya. So Prabhupada said, no, we are always in Maya, sometimes we fall in Krishna consciousness. That's our picture. We are always in Maya. In Maya means always enjoying mood. Always enjoying mood. In gross and subtle mood. It's a very, very important factor for sadhakas, for practitioners. Enjoying mood is very important. That's atyahara. Whatever is essential, needed, that is fine. But more than that is atyahara. That destroys bhakti. And then prayasas cha, over endeavoring. Endeavors are good. But over endeavoring is what? Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur explained over endeavoring means any endeavors other than Krishna is over endeavoring. That's simple. Any endeavors for Krishna, you want to chant 24 hours, who's going to stop you? Anyone? You chant throughout the year, 365 days. The whole Purushottam month. Chant day and night, who's going to stop you? That's not. No, husband cannot say to wife, you are over endeavoring. This is over endeavoring. No. This is endeavoring. It's a practice. You want to hear Hari Katha? Can hear hours and hours? This is endeavoring. It's not over endeavoring. But any other, which is not along with Krishna, aligned with Krishna, it's called over endeavoring. Even if it is 5 minutes. That's high standard. High standard. And imagine what is our standard. That's why we came to gold coast, on the coast of gold, on the shore of material world, where Mahaprabhu, he came from Shvetadeep to give us that golden opportunity. But Sri Prabhupada Saraswati Thakur is teaching us One chitosmi na sanshaya, vishvam gaura rasya magna, sparsha api tadat ave. I got bereft 3 times. One chitosmi na sanshaya, without any doubt, I'm bereft. When Mahaprabhu was and is giving his mercy, I'm just watching and lamenting. Because why? I don't want to give up my enjoying mood. It's too stubborn, too attached with that mood. And Mahaprabhu cannot be attained with enjoying mood. He is an extreme of renunciation. So only with the process of renunciation. And renunciation doesn't mean you have to become a sannyasi. A sannyasi can be enjoying more than a grastha. So there is no conservation kept there. No conservation kept there. Je bhajo se vado abhav nahi cha. Whoever worship Mahaprabhu or Krishna, he is superior. Doesn't matter which varna or ashram you are. So then what is the hope? What is the hope from Krishna? hopeless. Because he's very calculated. Why is calculated? Mukti dadati kahachit samana bhakti yoga. First time to Bhagavata. He can very easily give mukti, liberation. But he always hides his bhakti. And we are not running for mukti. We want bhakti. And that Krishna hides. Mukti dadati kahachit samana bhakti yoga. Very easily you can give mukti. And mukti means all facilities. So, liberation is in a very subtle sense, highest limit, extreme of enjoyment. Liberation. I want to have a Tesla car, this is my enjoyment. I want to have a apartment next to the golf course, this is also enjoyment. But I want liberation. So when you say, I want liberation, it appears like this is renunciation, that extreme enjoyment. Bhukti mukti dure parihar. Both has to be thrown away in the ocean. Bhukti mukti sriha yavat pishachi hidi vartate. Is compared to as the pitch was coming to endow you. The desire of bhukti. The highest extreme of enjoyment. When these two desires remain in the heart, how can that pure sublime Krishna, that golden Krishna prem can come sit in the heart? One thing obstructing all of us, the mood of enjoyment. So therefore renunciation is very essential. I was hearing one lecture of Srila Guru Gobind Goswami Maharaj, beautifully describing. Oh, sorry. Srila Radha Gobind Maharaj describing this. And very funny, like in Bhagavad, one of the Bhagavad Katas. He's saying, renunciation is very important. Very important. When you say, don't mind, I'm going to give you a very funny example. You are going to laugh. But that you make to understand. Without renunciation, you feel restless. And devotees are not understanding. Maharaj, what do you want to say? Without renunciation? He said, how much can you eat? All day you're eating, eating, eating. And what happened next day? In the morning, you have to renounce. It looks weird, but it's a fact. If you can't renounce, you have no horse to eat on. So renunciation is very important. Then he said, I'll give you another example. Man, if you go and look for a new house, and you see big, huge living room, big kitchen, or gym is there, bedroom, attached bath, bedrooms are there, five bedrooms are there, garage, everything is there. But you ask the guy who is showing you that house, I don't see any bathroom and toilet. He said, we don't have any toilet in this house. You're going to buy that house and there's no toilet? That's a place of renunciation. You can't even buy that house when there is no toilet. How fancy the house might be. So Maharaj was saying, this is how renunciation is so important for every individual. And as much as can you renounce and getting that qualification, qualified to achieve that goal for which we are striving. But if there is no urge, then everything is fine. But if there is urge and we want, then we need to have all of this. Renunciation. Very important. Then we can turn into gold. In this Purushottam month, it's a golden opportunity to worship Krishna, who is very calculated in nature. Ye yatha maam pravadante kaam sate vajame. Very great. You worship me in whatever degree, I respect you proportionately to you. Baba, Krishna, if you respect me proportionately, there is no ratio here. There is no proportion here. It's failure. Not failure, because your standards are very high. Can you show some compassion, some mercy? Krishna is wondering, me as Krishna, Sham complexion, bluish complexion, for me is very difficult. Because I am bound by my nature, and my nature is very, so much concentration, I am calculating. But I also have mercy, because devotees, they pray to me, hey Krishna, Karuna, Sindhu, when they say ocean of mercy, then I also feel something. Dina Bandhu, you are the savior of the fallen, then I also feel something, they are addressing to me. Then I have to become savior of the fallen, an ocean of mercy. But what can I do? My nature comes in. And I am very calculated. What can I do? I pray and request the most compassionate, my Radharani. She is not calculated. She has no consideration. She has only one consideration. What is her consideration? You only have this desire to love my Krishna. That's all. The rest I will take care of. That's her consideration. Catch my point here. Anyone just had this one little desire, you want to love Krishna, then I will arrange rest. Okay, Radharani, I have this desire to love Krishna. So how are you arranging this? I'm going to arrange this. How come? I will personally go and make those who are unqualified, qualified, to make them, to give them Krishna. I will personally go. And I will take Krishna with me. I will take Krishna with me. And I will make him see how the Karuna falls. What is the compassion means? I will take Krishna with me. So, Radha Bhav Dhuti Suvalitam Nomi Krishna Sarupam. She embraced Krishna. So tightly embraced Krishna, Krishna lost his complexion. Tat Kanchan Gaurangi, golden complexion, Radha Nami. Radhe Vrindavaneshwari. Don't keep any hope with bluish black. There's no racism here, from the material perspective, must be from spiritual perspective. Only those who are golden, we have great hope from them. So great hope from Tapta Kanchan Gaurangi, Radhe Vrindavaneshwari, Vishnu Sudhir Devi, Ramamami. Great hope from Radharani. From Krishna? With Krishna, hopeless ends. And from golden Radharani, endless hopes. From hopeless ends to endless hopes. She is giving that hope. She embraced Krishna and Krishna turned into golden. Namo Mahavadanyaya. Now he became a great donor. Before he was, now Mahavadanyaya. From hey Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dhina Bandhu, but actually personification of that savior of the fallen and the ocean of mercy. The personification is Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prem Pradayati. Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya. Namne Gauru Shiva. She is actually giving this. But as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Krishna is also present there. Krishna is also present there. Radharani is also there. Rasaraj Krishna and Mahabhav Sarupani Radharani combined. Karuna Sindhu, the ocean of Karuna and the embodiment of Karuna together. It flowed and tsunami came. And when tsunami comes, you don't have to go to the beach to take bath. Just by sitting at home, the water splash on you. Just by sitting at home, you get bathed with the ocean water, right? That's the whole tsunami. This is Mahaprabhu. Tsunami of compassion. By himself and his dear associates, sadhus. Oh, tsunami. Just by sitting at goal post, you're getting sadhu sambandhi. Srila Gurudev, Srila Prabhupada, that's the tsunami of Mahaprabhu. We were just sitting at our home. And this tsunami came and just inundated everyone, the entire world, with the golden opportunity, the access to that golden opportunity to attain that Krishna thing. That's the tsunami. The embodiment of mercy, of associates of Sri Radha. Gaur Premanande. Sachinandan. So in this Purushottam month, we are trying our best according to our qualification and understanding, our best to inspire not others but my own self and my foolish mind to be aligned with of the teaching of Sachinandan Gaur Hari Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, because it's a saying, first deserved and desired. But in Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu case, it's other way. For desire, then you get deserved. At least desire. Then I will arrange everything to make you deserve. There's the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and the associates of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the golden avatar and devotees. Hare Krishna. I was supposed to end 8 o'clock, Prakash Prabhu said, but I forgot the time.
Quick arti
and then elaborate prasad.
Then something happened. Shiva Jai Jai Gaurakande Haruki Kusho
आप बोलो
जय श्री श्री गुरु गोविंद प्रेम से वो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण दो गोपी गोवर्धन कोटि वैष्णव श्री पुरुषोत्तम मास की जय पुरुषोत्तम मास व्रत पालन करे पुरुषोत्तम श्री भगवान कोटि वैष्णव हरे कृष्ण महामंत्र जय गाय
श्रीमद्भक्तिवेदान्त सिद्धांत।